एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू बायोस्कूल। टुडेस टॉपिक इज फ्यूजन ऑफ स्पर्म एंड एग प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन एंड द प्रिवेंशन ऑफ पॉलीस्पर्मी इन मैमल्स। इन दिस टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ द स्पर्म एंड एग प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन दे गेट फ्यूज एंड व्हाट आर द प्रोटीन्स इन्वॉल्वड इन द फ्यूजन ऑफ स्पर्म एंड एग मेम्ब्रेन, एज वेल एज वी विल फोकस ऑन द प्रिवेंशन ऑफ पॉलीस्पर्मी इन केस ऑफ मैमल्स। एट द एंड वी विल सॉल्व सम प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू दिस टॉपिक। So let's have a look. So before going to the fusion of sperm and egg plasma membrane, what are the steps of fertilization? Okay, the first step of fertilization is sperm get activated by female reproductive tract. After the activation, sperm binds to the zona pellucida. When the sperm binds to the zona pellucida, that leads to the acrosomal reaction. After the acrosomal reaction, then the sperm it can lyse the zona pellucida layer. After that, there will be initiation of the sperm and egg membrane fusion. I have video on translocation and capacitation of sperms and the binding of zona pellucida and acrosomal reaction in mammal. I have given the link in the description box. So now, the how the sperm and egg membrane fusion takes place, we will discuss about that. So for the fusion of the sperm and egg membrane, the sperm it enter into the egg. In case of the mammal, the sperm enter into the egg in a horizontal direction, okay? But in case of the sea urchin, the sperm enter to the egg in perpendicular direction. This is the difference between the mammalian and sea urchin sperm entry to the egg. After the sperm enter into the egg, then how the fusion of sperm and egg membrane takes place? So this is the structure of the sperm, okay? So after the acrosomal reaction, what will happen? The inner acrosomal membrane, it will expose to the outside, as well as the ejomo protein which is present in the acrosome, it will get translocated to the sperm cell membrane. So here in the diagram, you can see the inner acrosomal membrane, it exposed to the outside as well as the ejomo protein which is marked in the red dots, okay? When the inner acrosomal membrane and the ejomo protein, they get translocated or exposed to the outside, now it can meet the CD9 protein on egg microvilli. Okay, this is the structure of the egg and the blue dot is marked the CD9. When the ejomo protein of sperm and the CD9 protein which is present on the egg microvilli, they are fused with each other, that lead to the sperm and egg fusion. So what are the proteins involved in the fusion of sperm and egg plasma membrane? That is the ejomo protein on sperm and CD9 protein which is present in the surface of egg. Okay. CD9 protein of egg microvilli and the ejomo protein of the sperm that leads to the entry of the sperm to the egg and the fusion of sperm and egg plasma membrane takes place. Now come to the prevention of polyspermy in mammals. We know what the polyspermy is. Polyspermy is the fusion of egg by more than one sperm. That is a problem for mammal, just as it for the sea urchin. Every animal, they prevent the polyspermy because that leads to the formation of abnormal embryo. In case of the sea urchin, as we have discussed in our previous video and I have also given the link in the description box, so in sea urchin the polyspermy is prevented by two methods, that is slow block to polyspermy and fast block to polyspermy. But in case of mammal, there is no fast block of polyspermy, there is only the slow block to polyspermy, because in case of the mammal, the fertilization takes place inside the female reproductive tract, so there will be a very less chance of entry of more sperms to female reproductive tract. That's why mammals, they don't have any fast block to polyspermy, they have only the slow block to polyspermy. So how the slow block to polyspermy in mammals takes place? After the sperm it enter into the egg membrane, then that leads to the cortical granule reaction. When the cortical granule reaction takes place, it releases the different enzymes. That enzymes, they modify the zona pellucida layer. The zona pellucida layer is the receptor for the sperm. If the zona pellucida layer is modified, then it cannot bind to the sperm, or the binding or the sperm which are bind to the zona pellucida, they get removed. Okay. So the cortical granule of the egg that contain the enzyme, that enzyme is called the N-acetylglucosaminidase. Okay. That contain the enzyme, that enzyme is called the N-acetylglucosaminidase. We know on the zona pellucida 3 or the ZP3, it has a N-acetylglucosamine. And to that N-acetylglucosamine, The sperm, it binds, but in acetyl glucosaminidase, the enzyme which is secreted by the cortical granule reaction cleave the N-acetyl glucosamine. Okay, so when the N-acetyl glucosamine is cleaved from the ZP3, then there will be no binding of sperm to the ZP3. So here you can see that the sperm, it binds to the N-acetyl glucosamine of ZP3. Okay, when cortical granule reaction takes place, secrete the enzyme. That enzyme is called the N-acetyl glucosaminidase. This N-acetyl glucosaminidase enzyme, it cleaves the N-acetyl glucosamine of ZP3. When the N-acetyl glucosamine of ZP3 get cleaved, then no more sperm can bind to the ZP3 layer. Okay, that is the modification of ZP3. It is the one step of prevention of polyspermy in case of mammals. The next one is the how the modification of ZP2 also takes place, because we know that after the sperm it bind to the ZP3, the sperm has to enter to the egg, so it pass through the ZP2. It binds the secondary binding of sperm is with the ZP2. So the modification of ZP2 is also required for prevention of polyspermy in case of mammals. So here in the diagram you can see that the after the sperm enter, or the sperm after the binding to the ZP2 layer, then there will be the cortical granule reaction. The cortical granule reaction, it will release here the cortical granule reaction takes place. In the cortical granule reaction, it will release the enzyme. That enzyme, which is called the ovastatin. That enzyme is called the ovastatin. This ovastatin is released by the cortical granule reaction. Then that ovastatin, it cleaves the ZP2. Okay, that is the ovastatin is a protease that cleaves the ZP2. So thus, the once the sperm has entered the egg, other sperm can no longer initiate or maintain their binding to zona pellucida, and they are rapidly shed. Okay, so when the cortical granule reaction takes place, then there will be lead to the modification of zona that prevent the polyspermy in case of mammals. So first, there will be modification of the ZP3. The ZP3, it is modified by the enzyme which is secreted by the cortical granule reaction is N-acetyl glucosaminidase, that cleave the N-acetyl glucosamine of ZP3, so that no more sperm can bind to the ZP3. Then second point is the modification of ZP2. How the ZP2 are modified? After the cortical granule the reaction, the cortical granule secrete the another protease that is called the ovastatin. Ovastatin, it help in cleaving or the modification of the ZP2, so that the sperm, it also cannot bind to the zona pellucida layer 2, that leads to the prevention of polyspermy in case of mammals. So here is the previous year question. Human sperms are allowed to fertilize ova having non-functional ovastatin. Here the ovastatin is non-functional. Okay, the following possibility may be significant in the fusion of the gametes. So what is the function of ovastatin? Ovastatin, it is synthesized by cortical granule reaction, and it is a protease that cleave the ZP2. Okay, that cleave the ZP2. Here the question is, the ovastatin is non-functional. It's non-functional means it cannot cleave the ZP2. Here in the option 3, the ZP2 will not be cleaved by cortical granule protease. Okay, because the ovastatin is non-functional. If ZP2 is not cleaved, then that lead to the polyspermy. It cannot prevent the polyspermy. So the option 5, polyspermy may occur frequently. Okay, so which combination of statement represent the outcome of the above statement? So the what are the correct option? The correct option is option 3 and 5. The 3 and 5, that is the option B is correct option. Thank you for watching my video. If you found this video useful, then please do like, share and subscribe. And bye bye. See you in my next video.